Hello folks, this is a Lenovo, Lenovo Thinkcentre M57, that's mic 57. This type is a 6072A5G. The configuration is Intel Core 2 Duo. It's an E6550 processor, which is 2.33 GHz Core 2 Duo, 4 meg cache. It came with 1 gig of RAM, DDR2 RAM, which is 667 RAM, and an 80 gig SATA hard drive. I'm actually going to upgrade this one to 2 gigabytes of RAM. I just want to show you how beautiful and easy these things are to open. It's built like a tank. It's got Windows Vista Basic. Can't see that because the camera's refusing to focus, but never mind. What you've got on the left and right hand side, you've got these little plastic buttons here, which basically push in. You see it's a two part case here. A little bit scratched, never mind. This was £37 shipped. So basically on each side of the case, you've got these little plastic buttons. Now what you do, I'll just put the camera to one side a second. Hopefully, there we go. What you do, you squeeze these in and lift up the case. And you can get inside the, it's on a hinge. So lift it right up, and there we go. You've got access to the case. You see here the plastic sliding actuating mechanism for opening the case. So inside we have an 80 gigabyte Western Digital SATA hard drive. You've got I put an extra graphics card in here. We didn't have a discrete graphics card, you just had an onboard Intel GMA graphics card. I think it's a 3100X3100. So there's no DVI or HDMI output. So I put in this old NVIDIA 9300GS card, which now gives me one DVI output and one VGA output, and also the onboard one. So I put that in. Otherwise I couldn't connect it to a digital monitor. It's brilliant. The way they design this is amazing. It's so serviceable. I mean, basically what you do, once you opened it, you just grab the front and flip it up, and you've got access to the CPU, cooling fan, speaker, power button, SATA combo drive. This is a DVD-ROM and CD writer, not a DVD writer. You've got your front USB ports there, and headphone and mic jacks, which is at the front, is this panel here. So you've got 1-2 USB there, power button there, and you've got hard drive and power lights on the right, just next to the power button. And yeah, basically the whole thing just swings open. Very serviceable. It looks like this unit has hardly been used. It came from a clearance broker on eBay. If you look at the fan, you can see the fan in there. There's hardly any dust on the blades of the fan whatsoever, so I think it's hardly been used. Now here you've got the Lenovo branding on the heatsink cowling. So basically the air is sucked through the front, through this vent here, and then I presume it goes through the fan, and then through the heatsink above the CPU, and then through the chipset heatsink, which you can see inside there, and then out the back, through these vents at the back, which I'll show you. Yeah, the vents at the back. Let me show you right round the box. So there we go. That's the rear. You've got six USB ports, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You've even got eSATA. This one's even got eSATA. This is the first computer I've ever had with eSATA on it. You've got VGA, parallel. You've got a COM port, serial port. You've got your audio jacks. You've got a power supply with a status LED. It's green when it's working. Standard IEC socket. Now, like I said, this is eSATA, There's the graphics card I put in, a 9300 GS. So that's I actually took my old graphics card apart and fitted it with two low profile brackets. As you can see inside, we've got two slots. The standard PCI slot, this white slot here, the back plate is taken up with the VGA output on the ribbon cable from the graphics card. So that's used up two slots, but never mind. Now to access the PCI slots, what you do, you use the plastic, lovely coloured blue, IBM coloured blue plastic clip, you flip this up and allows you to access the add-on cards, and back down again, that's locked. Fantastic. Such a simple design. Now this has got it's got Core 2 Duo E6550, 4 meg cache. It can take up to 8 gigabytes of DDR2 RAM. I've only got one populated at the moment, which is a 1 gig stick. The vendor accidentally sent me one stick too little, so I'm waiting for another 1 gig to arrive. I'll eventually put 8 gigs in the whole machine. As you can see, the board revision is Lenovo revision 1.0. So to get the hard drive out is very, very, very simple. You've got these two little, you've got this mechanism here, you've got a hinge, you've got a hard drive in a bracket here, and there's like a hinge at the front, and two little metal latches at the back. You basically push these in, they're quite stiff actually, they're marked with little blue labels on them. Push those in. I'll come back in a second actually, I'll just do those because it takes both hands. And I'll show you how to get the hard drive out. Back in a sec. Okay, so you push those two little levers in and lift this up. And I say it's on a hinge, but it's not a captive hinge. The hinge actually comes out. So you can basically lift the whole thing out like that. And you can remove the hard drive. Now you may be wondering how the hard drive comes out of the caddy. Well, let me show you in 2 seconds. I'll just pause the video and come back. So I'm going to remove all the... Actually, no, I can do it on screen, actually, probably. No, I can't. I'll come back. Okay, so when I first got this machine, I thought, how on earth does that hard drive come out of the caddy? Because it looks like there's machine press fitted fixings all the way around. 1, 2, 3, 4. You think the hard drive is stuck in there. Well, it's not. Look at the top. The top edge in the middle here, there's some flexible metal struts which go across the top of the drive. These are these long slotted struts. What you do is, it's very simple, just grab the hard drive and you bend the caddy outwards because those metal struts are flexible. You bend it, then the pins disengage from the side of the drive. Eventually. Anyway, you remove the drive. Basically, what happens is there's four little metal pegs that go in and sit in the holes in the drive, so they're holding the drive captive. But as soon as you pull this apart, it bends, it's flexible, it disengages. And to put it back in again, you basically get the drive and you position it above these two, position the two metal sort of folded over bars at the front into these parts here, these hinge parts here. They're like sort of retaining recesses. And then you get the SATA cable, data cable for the SATA. Plug that in. And then the SATA power. Oops. You plug in the SATA power, which I'm sure you've all seen a million times before. It's not very exciting. Plug that in, and you grab the drive, lower it down, and the latches go back into the plastic housing, which is next to or part of the heatsink housing. Push that in, and the drive's back in. So there we have it, folks. A Lenovo M57, which is actually model type 6702-A5G for golf. That is an internal tour. So, okay, yes, of course, and there's your... The cable clips are all in IBM blue. I'm not sure what these clips are made of. Some sort of tough plastic. To basically put it back together again, you basically flip the front down. Make sure it's not fouling anything inside. Shut it. Just push it down gently until it clicks. Actually, it's got back again, actually. Yeah, that's all right. That's okay. Making sure it's not fouling those cables down there. Push that down. And then push the front down. And then other side. It's clicked. It's shut. Back together again. Not a single screw in sight to remove this thing. Take it apart. Let's look underneath, shall we? What's underneath? There we go. Lenovo, copyright 2007. This machine was made in 2008. There's all your class marks and regulatory information. So there we have it. Thanks very much.